Okay, new video. Yeah, we've been busy for a while, so this is the first video in a week or so, I think. We have been a little bit distracted with making a new release and some fixes for the new release, which is not very much related to Cortex command, but I've also been working on some changes to the editor that should help us with being more productive in the future when making Cortex command and other games, since we're always developing the editor alongside the game. So adding a few more new tools. So I have a voxel object here, and I added a scale button. So let me duplicate this to show you. So you can now scale down objects pretty quick. So what this does is it halves the voxel resolution, so now what was previously 2 voxels should now be 1, and of course you can click this multiple times to make an even lower resolution version. And the reason I added this was that we were voxelizing a lot of objects, and I noticed that Dan spends a lot of time revoxelizing because the resolution didn't fit what we expected. It's quite important to get the right resolution, because if the resolution is too low, it doesn't look good, and if it's too high, it's too slow to edit and load for a game. So with this tool, it should be much easier to just voxelize something at a very high resolution, keep the original file, and then scale it down to whatever works for the specific project. And in the future, we can use the higher resolution object when our technology gets significantly faster. So another thing I worked on is a selection button here. So if you have an object selected, let's use this one. So you can click make shape here, and you will get a fitting shape selection. So this can be moved around. This is not the object, it's a shape that can be scaled and so on. This is useful because sometimes you want to edit the object using the shape tools, using all these things here like smoothen or whatever. And it's a bit of a pain to make a box and perfectly fit the box around the object. It's always slightly offset, and you have to look from different angles to get it right. So yeah, another small productivity boost. This also works with multiple objects. So if I have 2 here, rotate this a little bit or something. If I have 2 here, make shape, I get a box that perfectly fits the 2 objects, or as many as you want. This will also be useful for assigning material. So we have these like parts of the robot. If I have his head here or something, let's say I have his different parts here. One of them is the head, and I want to assign a material. I can make a shape, and I can use the selections down here to choose the material. Currently this is not fully implemented, I think, but there will be something like metal, and that metal has a different way it reacts to being shot and so on. So we will need to do this a lot, assigning materials to different objects, or also painting them on, which is perhaps also a possibility. Yeah, another thing that bothered me quite a bit when I was working with assembling these robots, it's a lot of little parts. As you can see here, it's like 10 parts or whatever. And I have all the separate limbs, like that's his lower foot, so it's a lower leg and foot, and then there's an upper leg and so on. And it bothered me quite a bit to work with this in the hierarchy. So these are the two objects I see on the screen here, and I often needed to select a whole group of objects or something like that. Also navigate deeper hierarchies. So I added some controls, the usual controls you have in hierarchies like that. So first of all, you can use the arrow keys up and down to go up and down in the hierarchy. You can also use arrow right here, for example, to expand something. And then you can use arrow left to jump back to the parent and once more to close it and so on. So if you keep doing this, you will close everything. And then secondly, I added multi-selections in the hierarchy. So this already works here. If I press Control, I can select two objects. Yeah. And now you can do the same in the hierarchy. So if I press Control here, now I have two or more objects selected and you can move them around together and all that. And I also added these other controls. So if you press Shift and arrow keys down, for example, you multi-select that way. Yeah, I think that's it. Ah yeah, another little thing that I worked on for the editor was, what happened a lot was this large terrain piece here. Let me remove this. So this large terrain piece here is basically always in the background when I want to select something. So if I have nothing selected here and I try to click this head and I miss or something, I always select the terrain piece. This also happens if I do a multi-selection. It will select the two pieces correctly, but also the terrain piece, which is in many cases not intended. So the way most engines solve that is by having some sort of hide or ignore selection here. So I added something like that as well. So here in the context menu of the terrain piece, I can now ignore select. So this object, this big terrain piece, is now not selectable. So whatever I do, I won't be able to select it. And the only way to select it is by choosing it in the hierarchy. And I can, of course, stop ignoring it to be able to select it again. Yeah, I also fixed some errors we had with the tools. It's not very interesting though. And we have been working on separating play mode from edit mode. So down here there's a switch now. It's currently in play mode. This means the scene is running, there's time and so on. And I can go to edit mode. And in edit mode, the scene is paused, so time doesn't move forward. And everything is basically suspended in its starting state. So when you can, this is where you will create your scene and then everything will start from there. So when we start the server, it will go into play mode and it will use that state. So yeah, this is pretty much it, I think. Yeah, so it was a more technical update. Let us know if this is interesting to you as well. I try to batch all these editor things together now, so I can increase my productivity, and after this I hope to focus exclusively on or almost only on writing gameplay code for a while before I do another batch of editor improvements. So yeah, let us know what you think. Any kind of thoughts are welcome, and we're very interested in reading your comments.